वेलकम टू रेडियो फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड माइक्रोवेव। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वेरिएबल अटेन्यूएटर। दिस इज प्रशांत, लेबोरेटरी असिस्टेंट, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ईसी। कमिंग टू द टेस्ट बेंच, हियर इट इज माइक्रोवेव पावर सप्लाई एंड माइक्रोवेव सोर्स। एदर वी कैन यूज क्लाइस्ट्रॉन Later, frequency meter, slaughter line section. This slaughter line section generally connected with detector to get output. But in this lab, we are going to insert this variable attenuator in between slaughter line to the detector mode.
Coming variable attenuator. So this is the component variable attenuator. And it consists of a micrometer reading. We have to take these readings corresponding to the input power and output powers. So this variable attenuator is inserted in between slotted line section to the detector mode, as we did in previous experiment, fixed attenuator. In fixed attenuator, we will get only a fixed value. So here we are going to get wide variety of attenuation constants like 0, 1 dB, 2 dB, 4 dB, 6 dB, 8 dB, 10 dB and more. Here I am removing detector mode. So while we are starting the experiment, this measuring reading should be equal to the 0. It's like screw gauge. We have reading starts from 0 millimeter. For 0 millimeter, it is showing 0.004 microamps. While I am rotating it into the one full count of rotation, it consists of 0.5 millimeter. At the point of 0.05 millimeter, I am getting 12 microamps as my output. And then 1 millimeter, it is 29. 1.5 millimeter, 61, 2 millimeters, 103, 2.5 millimeter, 153, 3 millimeter, 215, 3.5, 275, 4 millimeters, 344, 4.5 millimeter, 409, 5 millimeter 475, 5.5 millimeter 531, 6 millimeter 587, 6.5 625, 7 millimeter 670, 7.5 millimeter 698, 8 millimeter 715, 8.5 millimeter 732, 9 millimeter 760, 9.5 millimeter 765 itself. So 760 is the maximum output we are getting by using this variable alternator. So initially we have taken 860 as the Imax for the circuit. So before inserting alternator, we are getting currents as 860, and after inserting variable alternator, we are getting a range of 0 to 760 microamps of by substituting these values in a tabular column, we are going to get a different attenuation constant. By using this calibration of attenuator, we are going to find out attenuation of any component. Like, for example, at this point, variable attenuator, we are keeping any one of the component in our lab. For example, it may be a circulator. If circulator attenuates some power, then we will get a reduced output at the end. The input power to the output power, we are going to get how much attenuation it is given. So after completion of experiment and by taking these readings, so we have to disconnect these components. First we are removing detector mode, then variable attenuator. This detector mode is again connected to the slot line section for further experiment. Initial current for this experiment is 860. We have to note down it as Imax. It is used for the further experiment.
Coming to the calculations, here we applied Imax as 860 microamps. This is the tabular format to find out the readings. Micrometer readings in millimeter. We are tuning micrometer. We will get some currents, that is Ix, and finally we are going to find out what is the attenuation at that position. Alpha equal to 10 log of Ix. Alpha equal to 10 log of Imax by Ix. After filling this tabular form, at 0 meter, at 0 millimeter, we are getting lower currents like 004, and attenuation is 23.32. After tuning it into the 0.5 millimeter, current increased to the 12 microamps. Further, by substituting values into this formula, we are getting 18.55 dB. Then, by increasing in similar order, 0.5, 0.5 incremental order, currents are increased little bit. Further, attenuations also decrease. So finally, at 9 millimeter, I am getting current as 760, which is equivalent to the 0.5 dB attenuation. In a similar format, we are going to take the readings of variable attenuator. Thanking you.